3 by 5.
but
If you are going for a deviation, it will be, I think if you are leaving left hand side, and also number will be coming less. Divided by 1 plus 2 divided by 2. 3 by 2 it will be coming. You are taking only 4 edges. Am I correct?
Sir, 1 plus 2 into 2 divided by 5.
It will be 1.5. Anyway, this is one of the possible answer. If you leave it, then it is not the deviation for the entire data. Only half of the data I was seeing deviation. So that is the drawback of this. You should not leave all the data. You should not leave half of the data.
Sir, we can split the numerator into two parts, sir. One is that capital X is equal to M minus X plus X minus small x minus M. Can we do like that, sir?
You have to tell to the average people. You should not tell to intelligent people. Okay. So the other way is very simple. If you want to consider all the data, the other way is just the square and take a square root. See, what you have to do is, I have said, look at this equation. In order to avoid zero, you are taking modulus. Therefore, you have avoided zero and you got the value 1.2. You have taken all the deviations. Just putting modulus, you have avoided the negative direction and you got the values, you got the magnitude divided by 5. 6 divided by 5, you got 1.2. The other way is, instead of modulus, you square the deviations. Square all the deviations. You put square. You have introduced the squares. Since you introduced the square, you have to take it out. How to take it out the squares? How to take it out? Yeah, you have squared the deviations. If you want to take it out, since we have introduced, we have to take it out. Just put square roots. So take squares and put square root. You have avoided what you have done. By this way, you can't get the zero. So squaring the deviation and taking square root of it, you will get another way of avoiding the zero. Okay. So this is what we call root of mean of the squares of all the deviation, RMS. And this is what we call standard deviation. So the second is called the standard deviation. Okay. And this PPT is the explanation of all those things. Standard deviation. So the one you can see in red. Is there any way of avoiding the positive or negative direction of the deviation apart from taking modulus? The other way is square it. Square it. Since we are introducing the square, you take a root of it. So whatever you have introduced, that will be coming off. So it is summation of x square, I mean small x square divided by n and taking a square root of it. And this is what we call standard deviation, SD, standard deviation. And this is the better deviation of all. So it is better of range, quartile deviation, average deviation, and the standard deviation is better of the all four deviations. Okay. So it is otherwise called as RMS, root of the mean of the squares of the deviations from the mean. I think you can see it from the right hand side. I have taken the same data 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can see standard deviation, which is represented by the symbol sigma. See, minus 2 is our deviation for 1 that is being squared. Minus 1 is for 2, 0 for 3, 1 for 4, plus 1, and 2 for 5, plus 2 for 5. So square all the deviation. Square and then add, you will get 10. Divided by 5 means number of data. So 10 by 5 means 2. Take square root, because since you have square, take square root. You have avoided the squares. So square root of 2, it is 1.4. This is the better scores of spreadness. 1.414 is the spreadness in this data. So I have taken hypothetically 5 data. The spread in the 5 data is 1.414. Suppose what is the range of this? R is equal to
4.
See, the range is more. Range is 4. If you take average deviation, that will be 0. If you take modulus of it, it is 1.2. Standard deviation is 1.414. This is the better score, better deviated score. And what is the QD? You can easily find. What is the QD of this?
1.
I think it is Q3 minus Q1 by 2. I think it is 1, correct. 4 minus 2 divided by 2. 1. So QD is 1, which is not that much better data. Better spread score. So the better spread score is 1.414. So in this slide itself, you can get all the 4 scores. Range is equal to 4, QD is equal to 1, average deviation is equal to 1.2, standard deviation is equal to 1.414. So standard deviation is best. Okay. So you should remember, standard deviation is the root of the mean. Mean of what? Mean of the squares of the deviation. Mean of the squares of the deviation. You square all the deviation, take a mean of it, and then go for the square roots. So that's what we call standard deviation. A simple definition. If you want to remember, and this is the acronym. What is the acronym? RMS. We will tell now UPSC, Union Public Service Commission. So many things we may not be remembering. So we will go for acronym, BIPGR, the rainbow colors. If you want to remember, take the shortened BIPGR, violet, indigo, like that. We are going. So BIPGR, UPSC, TRB, whatever it is. Okay. What is the technique called this? What is the? So it's a memory technique. Whatever you are making an acronym of it. What is the memory technique called this? I am writing, but I am not getting. Mnemonics. M is silent. So mnemonics is the technique name for that. So mnemonic means taking only the letter, first letters. Union Public Service Commission. UPSC. Mnemonics. So likewise, I am taking only the first letter of the important words, key terms. RMS. Root of the mean of the squares of the deviations from their mean. Okay, for remembering purpose. Same thing is being repeated, but by this time I am going for the grouped data. This is how you have to find for your values, grouped values. So it is the summation fx dash square by n minus summation fx dash by n whole square. So here the square is within, here the square is for whole data into, this is a square, taken square root, and outside the square root you have multiplied by class interval times I. Okay, I hope we know a few things to remember from the previous calculation. This we very well the same data what I have taken, the same data I am taking throughout my discussion, same 11 classes. So you know how to find all those things, mean and norm, midpoint of the class, so all those things. So the first is this class, the second column is the frequency, the third column is the x dash for the value. I'm going for the fourth column headed by fx dash. So So we know f, we know x dash, f into x dash multiply, you will get the fourth column, fx dash. These fx dash, you multiply by x dash, you will get fx dash square. That is the fifth column. Simply, it's easy. You can go like this. That is the fifth column. Down below, you can get the summation. Summation fx dash, and here summation fx dash. Okay, right. So that's all. And now you have to go for a calculation. That's all. See, up to first column, you know, second column, that pink column, up to that you have calculated. This also fx dash, we know. Then the column 3 and column 4, if you multiply, you will be getting fx dash square. So now you got all the data so that you can turn to our molecular formula for standard deviation. I also, once again, I remember, I do not know how this formula has come. That is the problem sometimes. As I explained for RMS, I do not know how to explain this formula, how this has come. If I could, no, I will tell otherwise. Just let us take it as it is. If you could ponder over, you can, sometime you can try somewhere. Okay. So that's all, just substitution. Substitution from the previous table. Summation fx dash and summation fx dash whole square. Yes, you substitute here. See the value, standard deviation 11.335. So this is a better value for our grouped data. So always go into the standard deviation. It takes care of all the values. And it avoids also the negative direction. Okay, right. So now the assignment is for us. The assignment is you have to come up to this level. So up to last class, we stopped for range and quartile deviation. Now you have to calculate. No need to calculate average. You can leave average deviation. Go for standard deviation for the group data. Okay. So any questions up to now? If no question is there, now let us compare all the four dispersion for statistics on dispersion range, quartile deviation, average deviation, and standard deviation. Among the four, which one is least used?
Range, sir.
No, range is not. Average deviation is the least used. See, for to calculate class intervals and all, we have to go for range. To have class itself, we have to go for range. That is the first class. If you want to check in the first class, you can find range is useful to go for number of classes. Okay. Right. Which is the good statistics for dispersion, measures of dispersion?
Standard deviation.
Standard deviation. Why it is good score for measures of dispersion?
It takes care of all the data.
Yes, good. It takes care of all the data. That is why it is good. It takes care of all the data. Okay. Right. When we can use quartile deviation?
For the middle 50%.
Yes, that's all. If you want to know the dispersion of the middle 50%, then you can go for quartile. If you want to avoid the extreme score, low extreme, high extreme, if you want to know only the dispersion in the middle 50%, then you can go for quartile deviation. So that's all the comparison among the four things. And now I am presenting what I have said. Now I am presenting. So range. If only deviation at a glance is used, and if you do not know all the scores, you know only the highest score and the lowest score, then you can go for range and deviation at a glance. and quartile deviation in the central 50% of the score. And this is not at all used. And this is a stable score of deviation. And this is all as like mean. As like mean in the central tendency, standard deviation in case of dispersed score. Both mean and standard deviation, it is used to calculate higher order statistics.